Praise the Lord, church. Greets you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, who died and resurrected on the third day, and is seated at the right hand of God, interceding for us and interceding for his church. We want to praise him. We want to thank him for the arrows that the enemy threw at us and our families. God has protected us. We thank God that every member is safe, even though there were few attacks, but the enemy delivered us from it all. We thank him. This morning, we want to share a short exhortation. A lot of things are flying around. People are so afraid. Some people cannot even eat because of the things that are going around. What is the Lord saying? What is the message of the Lord for his church? And this morning, I want to share a short exhortation with you. I'll be taking the scriptures from Psalm 91. And this is what the Lord has laid on my heart to share with you as a church. And I read, "He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty." There's a confidence that we've expressed in our God, that our God is a shelter. He's the Lord of an ancient shelter. In Psalm 90 verse 1, he said, "Lord, through all generations you've been our home. Our God is a shelter. And anybody who runs to him for cover is safe." So this assurance that those of us who dwell in the secret place, and when we talk about the secret place, when we mean the presence of God, the presence of God, he's the Most High God, he's the Almighty, the Elohim, the Supreme One, the Mighty One, the Mighty One. He's the only one, the Most High. And then verse 2, "I shall say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in him I trust." What do you trust in? People trust in a lot of things. The other time I was watching TV, and some people from Aflawo, they were pouring libation. They were calling the ancestors because they trust in the powers of the ancestors. We trust in our Lord. Some trust in chariot. Some trust in arrow and bows. But we trust in our Lord. He will deliver us. He is our refuge. He is our fortress. He will fight on our behalf. Ah, our Lord, our Lord, ah, our Lord. Another verse 3. "Surely he will deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the perilous pestilence." Ah, the perilous pestilence that is happening. "He will protect us from deadly disease and even a destructive word." Our Lord, our Lord, our Lord, our Lord, our Lord. Our Lord, people, our Lord is a protection. He's a protection. The presence of God is a protection. And anyone who runs to him, he protects you. He will deliver you. Church, he will deliver you. Yours is to stay in the secret place, is to stay in the presence of the Lord. It is only when you stay in the presence of the Lord, you'll be covered. You are covered. And the verse 4. "He shall cover you with his feathers, and under his wing you will take refuge." When God is covering you, who can come near you? Who can? Who? Tell me who? Who? Tell me who? If God is covering you with his feathers, who can be against you? If God is with you, nobody. No power, no demon, no evil, no sickness. Because you are covered. Because you are covered with his feathers. His words shall take root. His truth shall be your shield and buckler. His truth. Our God is a protection. Our God is a protection. So when you wear Jesus, you are covered. You wear Jesus, you are covered. In those ancient times, when they were going for war, they wear apparel to cover themselves from their head to toe. Jesus is living in us, so you are covered. You are more than that Roman soldier. You are more than that Roman soldier. And you see, so for those who believe in their leaders, for those who believe in their leaders, who believe that their president is so powerful, where are they? Where are they? Where are they? They are looking for cover. But those who believe in their God, they shall do exploit. And I read from the verse 4. He shall cover you with his feathers. I read from the verse 5. You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow that flies by day. The terror by night. A lot of people are terrified. A lot of fear in the atmosphere. People are afraid to go out. People are afraid to even talk to people. But he said, you shouldn't be afraid. The terror that is coming by night, not the arrow that is flying by day, you'll be covered. People, you'll be covered. Only when you stay, you'll be covered. You'll be covered. You'll be covered. Our brother, one of our brothers was attacked by armed robbers. Last week. And because he was covered by the power of God, his life was spared. Because he's covered. Church, this is a living testimony. He says, you will be protected. You'll be protected. People, you'll be protected. It does not mean that the issue will not come. The troubles will not come. They will come. They will come, but they won't harm you. 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 And number 6, nor of the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor of the destruction that lay waste at noontime. Now people are afraid to even go out, to talk to people, to do things for their own. They said those things will be covered by it. And number 7, 1,000 may fall at your side and 10,000 at your right side, but it shall not come near you. This is the word of the Lord. Thousands are falling. Thousands may fall on your left. May fall on your right. We are hearing a lot of people believe in the word of God, don't believe in the news so much. A lot of us, we feed on news every now and then. I'm on a platform, and every now and then they are sending different type of people, different group of people who are dying, who are getting the infection almost every time. I've closed my eyes to all those things. I want you to, church, I want you to close your eyes onto all those things and believe and trust in God. Whose message are you trusting? Are you trusting the message of the Lord? Just like Caleb and Co. and said, we know that the guys who are there, we are like grasshoppers under their feet, but we shall overcome. But we will overcome. But we will overcome, because we are not overcoming because of our power, because of our abilities, but because of the God that we are serving. So you shall overcome. You shall overcome. The thousand fall. But it will not come in verse 8. Only with your eyes shall you see. So what? A lot of the things is only our eyes. And we'll see the reward of the wicked. People, this is the time we must get close to God. We must get close to God. We must get close to God. And then verse 9. Because you have made the Lord, who is my refuge, even the Most High, your dwelling place. Because you've made the God your dwelling place. You see, anybody who is on the wrong side cannot be defeated. You are on the lost side. Church, you are on the lost side. 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 You cannot be defeated. When you are dwelling in the Most High, he is the Elohim. He is the Supreme, the Mighty One. When you are dwelling in him, when you are dwelling in him, and understand, no evil shall befall you, nor shall any plague come near your dwelling. For 11, for he shall give his angels. Other version says, he will command his angels to take charge of you, to keep you in all your ways. Now the angels have been deployed to flying around and look for people that are covered by the blood. Are you covered by the blood? Are you covered by the blood? Are you covered by the blood? And that is only when you dwell. This is not a time for you to be messing around. This is a time for people to reflect on the word of God and to be in prayer. And I've been saying all the time, and I've been saying by the time, church, that as young people, we should not waste our energy on things that are not important, but things that are important. And this is the time for us to go to God every day and be praying and be feeding on His word, because we need His protection. 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 And then verse 12. In thy hands they shall bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. Huh? So the edges of God have been sent to bear you up, to carry you like air, that your foot will not even hit a stone. People, this is a God who me have tested this God. I know His power. I know His strength. I know His abilities. And this is the assurance He's given unto us. And then verse 13. You shall tread upon the lion and the cobra, the young lion and the serpent. You shall trample underfoot. The godly can trust God's protection and provision. And those who love the Lord will obey Him and seek His protection. He promises to answer us. Our Lord promises to answer us. We will tread upon the lion. We will tread upon the lion. We will go to places that are very dangerous. But God will come through for us. 14. He has set His love upon me. Therefore, the verse 14. Because He has set His love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high, because He has known my name. And 15, He shall call upon me and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life, I will satisfy him and I show him my salvation. A long life on earth represents just a small portion of the goodness of the Lord. There's an eternal friendship. People, God has brought His salvation unto us. Our job is to stay under His feet and believe in Him and do right. And I can promise you that the word of the Lord is true. Our God does not lie. Whatever He has said in His word will come true for us. It is for us to stay under His feet. I want us to take the word of prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank You for Your word. We thank You for speaking to us this morning. Father, my prayer is that, God, even as we reflect on Your word, may Your word have an impact in our lives. May we eat Your word. May we sleep Your word. May we walk Your word. It is only when, Father, we feed on this word that will be protected. We thank You. We bless You. So don't be afraid. The prayer team too have been praying for the church. We'll be meeting at least 2-3 times a week. Through virtual platform, and we've been praying for the church most of the nights. Don't be afraid. Just stay focused. Stay in His word, and you'll be covered. God bless you. Amen.